the previous class we solved the example problems in first lesson. Three example problems in first lesson. Today we will solve the exercise problem in this lesson. Okay, first problem. Two bodies have a mass ratio of 3:4. Two bodies have a mass ratio of 3:4. The force applied on the bigger mass produce an acceleration of 12 meter per second square. What could be the acceleration of the other body if the same force acts on it? So two bodies, mass ratio is 3:4. So what are the given values? There is an exercise problems. Exercise problems. So first problem, what are the given values? Given. So students, all of you take one note and note down the steps to be followed for to solve the problems. Okay. So first, the mass ratio of two bodies. Mass ratio of two bodies. Mass ratio of two bodies. M1 is M2 is equal to 3:4. Okay. So we consider the value of 4 is bigger than 3. So we consider the mass of the bigger body is 4. Consider mass of the bigger body. Mass of a bigger body. Mass of a bigger body is equal to 4 kilogram, that is M2. Mass of the smaller body. Mass of a smaller body. Mass of a smaller body. M1 is equal to 3 kilogram. Okay. Then what are the next given value? The acceleration is produced by the bigger mass. So acceleration produced by a bigger mass. Bigger mass. That is A2. Bigger mass is M2. So we have to, the acceleration we consider as A2 is equal to 12 meter per second. 12 meter per second. Then, so mass value is given and acceleration of the second value is given. What will you find out? To find acceleration of the smaller body. A1 is equal to question mark. Okay, what is the formula to be used to solve this problem? So formula is force F is equal to M into A. So okay, force F is equal to M into A. So you have to solve this first as the force is equal. So as the force is equal, so the solution F1 is equal to M1 into A1, F2 is equal to M2 into A2. Okay. So formula for force is equal to F is equal to M1 into A1, F2 is equal to M2 into A2. And then as force is equal, as we consider the forces as F, the forces are equal. As the forces are equal. Forces are equal. So we consider the two forces, it will be equal. Say F1 is equal to F2. F1 is equal to F2. So M1 A1 is equal to M2 A2. Substitute all the values, we will calculate the A2 value. So we want A2, M1 value is there, A1 value is there, M2 value is there. So we will find out A2 value. So A2 is equal to M1 A1 by M2. What is the M value? What is the M value? That is 3. What is the M2 value? M1 value is 3. And what is the acceleration value? A1, that is 12. 3 into 12. Then 3 into 12 by. So A1 value to be calculated. So A1, not A2. So A1 is, A2 is equal to M1 A1 by M2. But A1 is equal to M1, M2 A2 by M1. So substitute the M2 value, substitute the A2 value, and substitute the M1 value. m2 value is 4. So 4 into a2 value is 12 by m1 value is, what is the m1 value? That is 3. So 4 into 12 by 3. What is the value of 4 into 12? That is 48. So 48 by 3. 48 by 3. That is 16 meter per second. 16 meter per second. So okay. How will you how did you calculate this value? So first, what are the given values? Is the mass ratio of two bodies. Mass of the bigger body, consider mass of the bigger body, smaller body. Acceleration will be given for the first one body. Easily calculate the acceleration for the another one body. So what's the formula to be used? So what's the formula? Force F is equal to M into A. So if we consider the force are equal, the force acting between the first body and second, not a between. Force is acting on the first body, it will be equal to the force acting on the second body. So F1 is equal to M2, F2. M1, A1 is equal to M2, A2. So A2 is equal to M1 A1 by M2. So sub, and then we want A1 only. So A1 is equal to M2 A2 by M1. So substitute M2 value, A2 value and M1 value. We will calculate the A1 value. A1 is nothing but is the acceleration is produced by the smaller body. This is the final answer. Students, please note down the derivation. Note down the problems. What are the steps to be followed to solve this problem? Okay. Then go for the second one. What is the second question? A ball of mass 1 kilogram moving with a speed of 10 meter per second is reinforced after a perfect elastic collision with the floor. Calculate the change in linear momentum of a ball. One ball having mass 1 kilogram is moving with the initial speed, that is 10 meter per second. It will be collide with the wall, collide with the floor. It will be reinforced having the final velocity, that is 10 meter per second. So calculate the change in linear momentum of a ball. How will you calculate? First, what are the given value? What are the given value? Second problem, what are the given value? So one mass having a, one body having a mass 1 kilogram. So mass is 1 kilogram. Mass m is equal to 1 kilogram. Initial velocity, initial velocity. What is the initial velocity? First, the body having some velocity, that the velocity is initial velocity. That is u is equal to 10 meter per second. What is the final velocity? Final velocity is nothing but the body will be after the collision, the body having some velocity. That velocity is final velocity. So final velocity is so reinforced with one another. That is, so v is equal to minus 10, because reinforced means 10 meter per second. Opposite side. So final velocity is opposite in 10 meter per second. Reinforced means it will be taken as a negative value. So v is equal to minus 10 meter per second. What's the formula? So formula, linear momentum p is equal to m into v. Okay, linear momentum p is equal to m into v. What will you find out? To find change in linear momentum. Change in linear momentum. So change in linear momentum means solution. What is change in linear momentum? Change in linear momentum is equal to momentum before collision minus momentum after collision. So momentum, the difference between the momentum after collision minus momentum before collision. So mv minus mu. So first find out mv and mu. What is mv? So what is the mass value? 1. V is minus 10. So minus 10 meter per second. Kilogram meter per second. Then kilogram meter per second. Then mu, mass value is 1 and initial velocity is 10. So 10 kilogram meter per second. Now we will calculate change in change in momentum del P is equal to mv minus mu. So mv, what's the value of mv? Minus 10 minus mu is plus 10. So minus 20 kilogram meter per second. So it will be very easy problem. So first the body having some velocity, after collide with the floor they moving with the different velocity, it will be opposite of the first one. So the velocity, initial velocity is 10 and final velocity is minus 10. So easily calculate the change in momentum. Change in momentum is nothing but the difference between the after collision, momentum of after collision minus momentum of before collision. So mv minus mu, so mv value, mv first calculate and mu another otherwise calculate. So next we will calculate the difference between mv minus mu. This is the final answer for this problem, that is the change in momentum is equal to minus 20 kilogram meter per second. Then go for the third one. What is the third problem? That is, a mechanic unscrew a nut by applying a force of 140 Newton. A mechanic unscrew a nut. Or mechanic nut unscrew pandraru by applying a force of 140 Newton. That is, spanner length is 140 Newton with a spanner of length 40 centimeter. Sorry, the spanner length is 40 centimeter, but the man applying the force is 140 Newton. And what should be the length of the spanner if the force of 40 Newton is applied to the unscrew the same nut? So first, the person applying the force having a spanner with the length 40 centimeter, what should be the length of spanner having to be applied at the force 40 Newton? So first, what are the given value? What are the values are given? So first, force is applied by the person. First force is applied by the force person F1 is equal to 140 Newton. So F1, first force is F1 is equal to 140 Newton. The second force F2 is equal to 40 Newton. Okay. The spanner length, that is L1, is equal to, spanner length L1 is equal to 40 centimeter. So 40 centimeter you have to convert to meter. So 40 into 10 power minus 2 meter, minus 2 meter. Okay. Then L1, then to find what the value we will find, so length of the spanner L2 is equal to length of the spanner L2 is equal to question mark. So F1 is given, F2 is given, L1 is given, we will find out the L2 value. So what's the formula? Moment of force, tau is equal to F and D. D is the distance. This problem, D is considered as a length. So tau is equal to force and length, that is L. So tau is equal to F and L. Then solution. So solution, the tag moment of forces will be created by the two length, spanner length, it will be equal. So tau 1 is equal to tau 2. So F1 into L1 is equal to F2 into L2. So first force applying by the spanner L1. Second force applying the force by spanner L2. So we will calculate the value of L2. So L2 is equal to F1 into L1 by F2. Substitute the F value and L value and F2 value. So F1 value is 140 and L1 value is, L1, what is the L1 value? 40 into 10 power minus 2. What is the F2 value? 40. So 40 cancel, remaining 140 into 10 power minus 2. 140 into 10 power minus 2. 10 power minus 2 is 140 by 10 square. 10 square is nothing but that is 100. So 1.4 meter. So the spanner of the length is equal to 1.4 meter. So this problem, F1, F2 value is given and L1 value is also given. We will find out the length of the spanner. So this problem is nothing but one person taking a spanner. First, the spanner length is 40 centimeter. That the spanner is giving the force is 140 newton. Second, that the same person, what the spanner will take to applying the force is 40 newton. So L2 value will be calculate. So L2 first choose the formula for that problem. The formula is tau is equal to F into D. So tau value is T, it will be mentioned in this problem is L. So tau is equal to F into L. So solution F into L1 is equal to F2 into L2. So we will consider the tag is presented by the first spanner is equal to tag is presented by produced by the second spanner. So F1 and L1 is equal to L2 F2 into L2. We calculate L2. So L2 is equal to F1 and L1 by F2. Substitute all the values, we will calculate the answer. Then students note down the steps. Okay. Then go for the fourth one. What is the fourth problem? The ratio of masses of two planets. Ratio of masses of two planets is 2:3. Okay. The ratio of their radius is 4.7. Find the ratio of their acceleration due to gravity. Mass ratio is given, radius ratio is given. We will find out the ratio of acceleration due to gravity. So what are the given values? Fourth problem, the given. So mass ratio is mass ratio of two planets, mass ratio of two planets, mass ratio of two planets, that is m1 is to m2 is equal to, that is 2:3. So mass of the smaller planet is 2, mass of the bigger planet is 3. Okay, mass of the smaller planet, we consider mass of the smaller planet and mass of the bigger planet is 3. Okay, 2 kilogram and 3 kilogram. Then radius ratio of two planet, radius ratio of two planets is equal to, so R1 is to R2 is equal to, R1 is to R2 is equal to 4:7. So R1 value is 4 and R2 value is 7. Okay, so ratio of first planet and ratio of second planet. So 4:7. What will you ask in this question? What is asked in this question? To find ratio of acceleration due to gravity. Ratio of acceleration due to gravity. G1 is G2 is equal to question. So mass ratio is given, radius ratio is given, and we will find out the ratio of acceleration due to gravity. How will you find out? What's the formula is we used to solve the problem? What's the formula? So relation between G and G. What is the relation between G and G? Acceleration due to gravity. G is equal to Gm by R square. This formula will be used in this problem. So solution. Acceleration due to gravity of first planet. G1 is equal to Gm1 by R1 square. Okay. And acceleration due to gravity of second planet. G2 is equal to Gm2 by R2 square. Okay. What will you find out in this question? The ratio of G1 is to G2. So ratio of G1 is to G2 is ratio of acceleration due to gravity is gravity G1 is G2 is equal to G1 by G2. So G1 by G2 is Gm by R1 square, Gm1 by R1 square into R2 square by Gm2. Okay, G cancel, then M1 is will be taken out this side. Say M1 by M2 in R. what is the m1 value, what is the m2 value, what is the r2 value, what is the r1 value. Substitute m1 values, m1 is 2, so 2, m2 value is 3, so 3, r2 value is 7 by r1 value is 4, the whole square. Okay, so 2 by 3, 7 by 4, the whole square. So 2 by 3, the 7 into 7 by 4 into 4. Then 1 2s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. So 7 into 7, that is 49. 49 by 3, 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 24. So 49 by 24, that is g1 by g2. So the ratio of acceleration due to gravity is acceleration due to gravity is 49 by 24. Okay, so this is the acceleration due to gravity of two planets, that is the 49 by 24. So what are the given values? That is the ratio of the mass ratio is given and radius ratio is given. We will find out the acceleration ratio. So we consider the formula g is equal to gm by r square. So substitute the g1 value and g2 value and substitute the m1, m2, r1, r2 value. We will find out the ratio of acceleration due to gravity. Okay. Then the fourth problem in the exercise will be over. Next we will go for the hard question. Hard question. Hard question one. That is, hard question is one. Exercise problem is there. There are hard questions. The students must note down the steps to be followed to solve the problem. So, what's the first hard question problem? Two blocks of masses 8 kg and 2 kg respectively. Two blocks having the mass is 8 kg and 2 kg. So m1 is 8 and m2 is 2. And lie on the smooth horizontal surface. So we have to calculate the total mass, that is m is equal to m1 plus m2. And it will be contact with each other. They are pushed by the horizontal applied forces 50 newton. Calculate the force exerted on this 2 kg of mass. 2 kg mass ki evlo force apply panam. Okay ma'am. So what are the given values? That is, what are the given values? Mass m1 is equal to 8 kilogram. Mass m2 is equal to 2 kilogram. So total mass m is equal to total mass m is equal to m1 plus m2. So 8 plus 2 kilogram. 8 plus 2 kilogram is equal to 10 kilogram. Okay ma? This is the total mass. Then next, what is the given value again? The force F1 is given. So force F1 is equal to 15 Newton. Force F1 is equal to 15 Newton. So we will find out the force F2. Okay, ma? So to find force F2 is equal to question mark. Force F2 is equal to question mark. So what's the formula? Force F is equal to m into A. So this formula is will be used to solve this problem. First we will find out the acceleration, next we will find out the force. Okay, so first solution, how will you find out the acceleration A? The two bodies having the same acceleration A, so commonly is no doubt F is equal to m into A. So F is equal to m into solution, the force F is equal to m into A. Force F is equal to m into A. So we will on A, say F by M. What is the F value? That is 15 Newton. First force, that is F1. 15 by total mass is 10. Total mass M is equal to 10. So 15 by 10, that is acceleration is 1.5 meter per second square. So now we find out the acceleration value. So a is equal to 1.5 meter per second square. We will find out the F2 value. So force F2 is equal to, force F2 is equal to the two bodies having the same acceleration but different force. Okay. F2 is equal to M2 into A. What is the M2 value? That is 2 kg and A value is 1.5. So 3 Newton. So F2 is equal to 3 Newton. So how will you find out, how did you find out this F2 value? So two masses, two bodies will be contact with one another, two bodies having the different mass. So you add, you will first calculate the total mass of these two bodies, and force F1 is, it will be given. The second force we will find out. So for first we take the formula, F is equal to M into A. So F is equal to M into A, first find out the A value, that is 1.5 meter per second square. Now we want F2 value. Suppose F2 is equal to M2 into A, because the two bodies are having the same acceleration. So M2 into A2, sorry, M2 into A, substitute the A value, substitute the M2 value, F2 is equal to 3 Newton. This is the final answer for this problem. Then go for the last problem, go for the second hard question. Second problem, that is the heavy truck and bike are moving with the same kinetic energy. We will choose the two, truck and bike. They are having the same kinetic energy, okay? So what is the meaning that kinetic energy? Any one body to be move having some energy, that is the kinetic energy. So if the mass of the truck is 4 times that of the bike. The mass of the truck is 4 times the mass of the bike. So mt is equal to 4 times mp, okay? Calculate the ratio of the air momentum. So, moment out ratio in and get down, okay, ma'am. So, first the given value, what are the given values? Second hard question, what are the given value? That is kinetic energy of truck, kinetic energy of truck, it will be equal to kinetic energy of bike. Kinetic energy of truck is will be equal to kinetic energy of bike. So, this is the given value, that is the kinetic energy of truck is equal to kinetic energy of the bike. What is the formula for kinetic energy? That is half mv square. Kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. First, truck, so half m, truck means, is put the suffix t, v t square is equal to, kinetic energy of bike means half m p v p square. Okay, this is the kinetic energy formula for truck and bike. So half mv t, sorry, mt v t square is equal to half mb v b square. What are the other given values? Also, mt is equal to also mass of the truck, it will be 4 times the mass of the bike. So mt is equal to 4 suffix mb, okay ma'am. Then so this is the given values to find. What will we find? Ratio of their momenta, ratio of their momenta, ratio of their momenta. What is the meaning that momenta? That is P1 by B2. Momenta PT by momentum, truck momentum by bike momentum. It will be equal to question mark. PT by PB is equal to question mark. Then formula. What's the formula to use to solve this problem? So momentum, linear momentum formula is, formula for linear momentum, linear momentum, P is equal to mass into velocity. Okay. Then, how will you solve this problem? Solution. First, we will choose this equation is considered as equation 1. This equation is considered as equation 2. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Equation 2 in equation 1. We get. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. First, half m, mt. Mt is 4mp. So, 4mb and vt square. Vt square is equal to half mb vt square. Okay, vb square, not a vt square, vb square. Okay, then Common terms will be Strigo half of cancel and MBMB is cancel. T square is equal to 4VT square is equal to VB square. So VT square is equal to VB square by 4. Okay. So this is the one term. So VT is equal to. So 1 by 2 VB. This is the common term. VT is equal to half into VB. So this is the velocity of the truck. VT is the ratio of the, next we will calculate the ratio of the linear momenta. How will you calculate the ratio of the linear momenta? A ratio of linear momenta. Ratio of linear momenta PT by PP is equal to. PT means MT and VT by MB and VB. So MT, VT by MB and V. Substitute the MT value and MB value. Substitute the MT value is, MT value is 4 MP and VT value is half VB by MP and VB. So this is the MT value is 4 MP. MT value is 4 MP and VT value is half VB. Then strike out the common terms in the numerator and denominator. MP, MP cancel and 2 is 2 and VB also cancel. Then PT by PB is equal to 2 by 1. That is the ratio of VT by VB is equal to 2 by 1. Suppose we will consider the ratio of momenta of bike by momenta of the truck, VT is equal to 1 by 2. So this is the ratio of their momenta of truck and bike. So truck, bike, the rendered ratio of linear momenta, this is the law's answer. So how did you calculate this value? So first we will choose the ratio of the linear momenta formula, and next we will find out the VT value, and next the VT value and MT value will substitute in this ratio of their linear momenta formula, and we will calculate the BP by BT is equal to 1 by 2. So this is the solved problem. So 4 exercise problem and 2 hard question we will work out today. So home assignment for today. Home assignment. Learn the formulas and work out the same exercise problems. Work out again the same exercise problem. So today homework is learn the formulas in this lesson and then work out the same exercise problem. Okay, thank you.